Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel and another episode of Travel and Decor. Would you care to guess where I am? You are correct, I am in Amsterdam. And right now, exactly, I am standing in Dam Square. Behind me in this direction is the red light district. Today is Friday. Tomorrow and Sunday, we will be visiting the Design Icons trade show. It's one of Europe's largest vintage furniture and vintage home decor trade shows. Of course, I will be showing you sights and scenes of the city, also museums and places I highly recommend. But first of all, let's get started with the highlight of this video, our featured old historic hotel. Founder of the hotel was a German immigrant by the name of Adolf Wilhelm Krasnopolsky, who lived from 1832 to 1912. The hotel sits where a coffee house was located that he bought in 1866. Around 1879 or 1880, he bought the neighboring house and fitted it with his first hotel room. For the International Colonial Expo in 1883, A.W. Krasnopolsky expanded further, building the Grand Hotel with 125 rooms in the style of Belle Époque. At that time, it was the only hotel in Amsterdam with running water and a telephone in every room. Today, the five-star hotel on the Dam Square in the center of Amsterdam boasts 451 rooms, winter garden, restaurants, and a boat dock, as well as apartments on the Uderzeits Vorburg Waal Gracht. We chose to stay in one of the apartments with a beautiful view of the Gracht or canal. In his early years in Amsterdam, after a long day's work as a tailor, A.W. Krasnopolsky would seek relaxation in one of the coffee houses around Dam Square, where he befriended the waiter, August Vollmer. Mr. Vollmer convinces Krasnopolsky to take over the rundown cafe in 1866. It quickly becomes one of the most famous cafes in Amsterdam. Even though much has changed, excellent quality, good products, and a warm atmosphere are still the ingredients of the Grand Café Krasnopolsky today. I recommend making lunch reservations, even if you are a guest at the hotel, because the café is also very popular for those not staying at the hotel. With the tailoring diploma in his pocket, the young clothier Krasnopolsky secures his first job in Amsterdam at Winkel van Sinkel. Yeah, that's the true name, Winkel van Sinkel, following in the footsteps of his father and grandfather. At the cocktail bar, The Tailor, they pay tribute to the old craft of the founder with tailor-made and bespoke cocktails. The art of tailoring is stitched inseparably together with the menus and the decor. In its heyday, the Winter Garden Room was decorated with exotic plants and Edison lamps. For that period, the use of glass and cast iron and electric lighting were rare. due to historic conservation laws, this original part of the hotel cannot be touched or changed, but who in their right mind would want to? This gorgeous, majestic greenhouse-styled room sets the perfect atmosphere for an elegant morning meal. Dam Square is located in central Amsterdam, with the infamous red light district starting behind it. The most historic buildings here, other than the hotel, are the New Church and Dam Palace, the Royal Palace, built from 1648 to 1665 and was originally used as a state/government's house. But in 1808, it was used as the official residence of the king. But since 1939, it has been used mostly for official presentations and as a guest house for state officials. I was lucky one day to catch the military band's performance, plus presenting and changing of the King's Guards in preparation for the arrival of the President of India. If you bring a few treats, you can make some new friends. There are people selling handfuls of rice, but better for the birds are some bread or cracker crumbs. The Rijksmuseum is probably the most famous of Amsterdam art museums, housing tens of thousands of Netherlands and Flemish art, especially the Great Hall of Masters, including Judith Leister, who was the first woman to become a master painter in the Netherlands. She received this title in 1633 after being admitted to the Harlem Guild of St. Luke. The famous The Night Watch painting from Rembrandt is nearly 400 years old. It is no wonder that the painting showed signs of aging, such as discoloration and cracks in the paint layer. Restoration efforts started in January 2022. Currently, deformations in the canvas have been reduced, and the painting has been mounted into a tension of spring systems. This ensures that the tension of the canvas is optimal and always evenly distributed. The Rijksmuseum's Art Historical Library is the largest of its kind in the Netherlands. Completed in 1881, the library has largely retained its original form and ornamentation. The library is still, till this day, used by art historians and restorers, respectively, view the room in complete silence in order not to disturb their work. But just as impressive is the Van Gogh Museum. It not only houses the works of Vincent Van Gogh, but also of many artists that influenced him. Just be careful to not get caught filming, as I did. Luckily, I had mostly completed the museum tour. So take a note to self. Van Gogh Museum, pictures are allowed, filming not. But I only find this rule to be true in this particular museum. Another note, the museum, as well as others, can quickly book out, so it is necessary to book in advance and buy tickets online, as for most of the museums. For this reason, I was unable to visit the Anne Frank Museum. It was literally booked out for the next 3 weeks. If you are a fan of sailing ships or just curious about the Gilded Age of the Netherlands when they ruled the seas, you cannot miss out on visiting the National Maritime Museum, including the chance to board an original ship of the 17th century. This was the only museum where we were able to just go and buy tickets at the door. Thank you. Going back to masters of the Netherlands, one of the most famous was Rembrandt van Rijn. You can visit his house literally frozen in time from when he lived and worked there between 1639 and 1658. If you are truly a time traveler that enjoys going back in time, then you must visit the Museum van Loon. Wilhelm van Loon co-founded in 1602 the Dutch East Indian Trading Company, and the interior decor of the home reflects his worldly travels and extreme wealth. The house was designed and built in 1672, first belonging to painter Ferdinand Bol, a student of Rembrandt's. It remained in the Van Loon family until 1960, and only a handful of modern mid-20th century portraits reveal the last of the family members who lived there. Another time traveler is the Museum Ons Lieve Heer op Zolder, which means Our Lord in the Attic, and is one of the many Catholic hidden churches in Amsterdam dating in the period from 1578 to 1853. After the Netherlands gained back their independence from Catholic Spain, the Netherlands became solely Protestant and all of the city's churches were converted to Protestant. All other religions were tolerated as the new Dutch Republic was based on freedom of religion and freedom of conscience, and a blind eye was turned to private, unofficial church facilities like one that may uphold the rituals of the Catholic Mass in the home. This led to many wealthy residents of Amsterdam converting a portion of their home to a house of prayer. Our Lord in the Attic, belonging to Jan Hartman, is a massive example of a private church of worship and spans over two connecting attics and several floors, including private quarters for the live-in priest. Let's go back to Dam Square. If you are in the mood for some luxury shopping, I highly recommend De Bijenkorf. Luxury shopping a la Bergdorf Goodman's or Saks Fifth Avenue. Thank you. For a quaint brunch or lunch, I enjoy the French restaurant Red in the Kaisersgracht 594, a truly warm Parisian ambiance in the heart of Amsterdam. You will see later, my favorite restaurants seem to follow a color theme. If you are a jazz fan, I highly recommend the Beam Huis or Beam House. Make sure you make reservations and enjoy a delicious meal and drinks in the Beam Café before the concert. Don't let the title Café fool you. It is a full-on restaurant with many course selections to choose from. With a drink in the hand, you enter a Greek theater-styled auditorium with the best acoustics and views of the cities and passing trains. This Michelin star restaurant led by chef Jacob Jan Berma is the highlight of the hotel. The name is derived from the historical name of the room, De Witte Saal, that was given to the restaurant when it first opened in 1885. The room is listed as a monument and is considered to be the oldest restaurant of Amsterdam in original condition. Reservations are highly recommended and to be made as early as possible. The 7-course meals, a vegetarian version is also offered, are culinarily curated to perfection for each night. This is the ultimate fine dining experience, and expect the check to reflect that standard also. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and there are more to come. Where are we going next? Portugal. And if you want to see what I bought at the Design Icons, make sure you subscribe and turn on your notification bell so you know when the next video is uploaded. And as always, yours truly, Heart Makin'.